Top of the hour, we'll getting all these pictures from New Delhi at the DRDO conference, where the National Security Advisor Ajit Doval is meeting the tri-services chiefs, where we have also accepted pictures of Raksha Mantri Rajnath Singh, who's paying tribute to the former president APJ Abdul Kalam on his 88th birth anniversary. The National Security Advisor meeting Army Chief General Bipin Rawat, the Indian Air Force Chief, Air Chief Marshal R.K.S. Bhadauria, and the Navy Chief Admiral Karambir Singh, the DRDO Chairman as well at the DRDO, that is the Defence Research and Development Bhavan, for the 41st DRDO Directors Conference. Now, this conference that is being held in New Delhi, also you have the DRDO, the Chief there, the Prime Minister today as well, paying tribute to the former President Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, to pay a tribute to him. And he stated that the former president had a dream capable of prospering India in the 21st century, remembering the great contributions that was made by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam.
And have had many success stories. And all these success stories are a result or born out of close cooperation and a long relationship together. We have the Hamsa series of sonars, which are a standard fit on our ships. We've got the Varun Astra, the heavyweight torpedo, which is going to again become a standard heavyweight torpedo on our ships. The Marich, the decoys. The Ushus, which is now the sonars of choice for our submarines. The Tal torpedo, lightweight torpedo. The Vesi, along with DRDO, that has done a lot of work on networking, which is one of the niche areas that we need to get into the Navy. The Arnav gaming software. The software-defined radios, which are going to be the future of our communications between the ship, submarine, aircraft. And also we've had some success stories in joint development, like the BrahMos surface-to-surface missile, and of course the MRSAM. There are, as we speak, there are 98 ongoing projects with the DRDO, and I know for sure that 19 mission mode projects are doing extremely well. So I want to compliment DRDO for that. And also accept the fact that DRDO is extremely important to the Navy to maintain this technological edge, which is so crucial to naval warfare. When we speak of warfare, actually warfare and technology are synonymous. And warfare is changing at a rapid pace because it's being driven by technology. So therefore, it is very necessary for us to have a technologically up-to-date force. And here I want to contextualize the DRDO mission statement with this aspect of having a technologically updated force. And I want to quote the mission statement of DRDO. I quote, "It is to provide defense services decisive edge by equipping them with internationally competitive systems and solutions," unquote. In pursuit of this mission statement, I think there are two key determinants, which I call the two T's. One is time, because that isn't of essence in any military development project. If you can incubate and execute a particular technology, only then will you be able to harness this contemporary technologies, which are themselves galloping ahead. So time is of great essence. And second, of course, is technology. And here I would like to quote our Honorable Raksha Mantri. He had said this in a couple of seminars earlier, and I want to quote, "When nations go to war, the nation with better technology will win," unquote. So for us in the Navy, maintaining the right technological mix is very crucial. To my mind, ideally, the Navy must have a few percent, maybe 15-20% of slightly vintage, of vintage systems, but the bulk of the systems have to be contemporary. And then another small percentage would comprise, you know, cutting-edge technology which is being incubated or which is being imbibed into the service.